Hello students, you have studied about functions, also about derivatives. So we'll study some applications of the derivatives. So beginning directly going into that, I will discuss few concepts. So we'll study today one theorem. So to study that theorem, some basic definitions, basic concepts we need to know. That is nothing but the first one is relative extremum, or I can also say call it as local extremum. So what is relative extremum? I can say in a simple words that if it has a relative maximum or a relative minimum, then it is nothing but it is having a relative extremum at a point say C. Now one more confusion starts. What is relative maximum? What is relative minimum? The question arises there. So first we'll see what is relative maximum, then we'll see what is relative minimum. Now I'll consider a graph. You know that this is x-axis, this is y-axis. So if I draw a graph, obtain a graph this way, for example, you are throwing a ball. From here I am throwing to you. So you'll get a somewhat this type of curve. So I'll consider the interval, open interval A and B. So you know what is the meaning of open interval, that the endpoints are not considered here, only the points between A and B are considered. I'll also consider a point X and X. Now at this point C, I can say that there is a maximum value. When I can say that, if f of x is less than or equal to f of c. If the function value at this point, that is f of x, and also at this point, that is f of x, if all the function values within this open interval a and b, if it is less than the function value at the c, that is f of c, then I can say that it is having the relative maximum value or the local maximum value. Now one more thing I said, that is nothing but the relative minimum value. Clearly I'll consider one more graph. That is nothing but think this way. So here also I can consider an open interval A and B. I can consider a point X. I'll get a point C where the value of that graph is very minimum. When compared to all the values in the graph, the value at this point is minimum. So I can say that if f of x is greater than or equal to f of c, then it is having the relative minimum value or the local minimum value. So if the graph has either the relative maximum value or the relative minimum value, then we call it as it is having the relative extremum value at the point c, which belongs to the open interval a comma b. So you have come to know what is relative maximum, relative minimum, and also the relative extremum. Now we'll learn one theorem related to this concept. That is nothing but they say that if f of x exists and for all x in the open interval a comma b, and also you're having f is having the relative extremum value. So you know that extremum value means it may have the maximum value or it may have the minimum value. And if I get the point C such that C lies between A and B, means C is belonging to the open interval A and B, then also if the f dash of C exists, then this f dash of C is equal to 0. So what are the given? When we go to prove a theorem, we first consider what is given, what is to be proved, then we go with the proof by using the known concepts. So what is given? That is the function value exists for all x belongs to a comma b, and also it is having the relative extremum value, and f dash of c exists. What you have to prove is f dash of c is equal to 0. To prove this, there are two cases. That is, it may have either relative maximum value or the relative minimum value. I'll consider that it is having the relative maximum value. So I have already said the definition. Using the definition, I can say that f of x is less than or equal to f of c. So if I do some alteration in this, I can say that f of x minus f of c is less than or equal to 0. So you know that in the theorem statement itself, it is given that f dash of c exists. So f dash of c, using the limit function, we can write it as limit f of x minus f of c divided by x minus c as x tends to c. Now the question arises whether this x is less than c or x is greater than c. But we know that by the definition, since we have considered it as having the relative maximum value, f of x is clearly less than f of c. But we don't know whether x is less than c or x is greater than c. So once again here two cases arise, that is either x may be less than c or x may be greater than c. So I'll consider the first case, that is x is less than c, our first case. So x is less than c, then what will happen? X minus c will be less than 0. So now I'll substitute in this condition which we have got, I'll name it as 1. So here f dash of c is equal to limit f of x minus f of c divided by x minus c. So here x less than c means what? The x is tending towards c from the left hand side. So here minus x tends to c from the negative end or the opposite, sorry, from the minus end. So we will get here f of x minus f of c, say we know that it is less than or equal to 0, whereas x minus c, it is less than 0. So he will get numerator is negative as well as denominator is negative. So we will get a positive value. That is nothing but f dash of c is less than or equal to 0. Now one more case, I said there are two cases. The second case is nothing but x is greater than c. So if x greater than c, then what will happen? X minus c is greater than 0. So I'll apply in this first one once again. So f dash of c is equal to limit f of x minus f of c divided by x minus c. Now the x is tending towards the c from the positive end, that is x tends to c plus. So now what will happen? Numerator, clearly it is less than or equal to 0. But what about the numerator? It is greater than 0. So we will get numerator negative and denominator positive. So we will get a negative value. So we will get f dash of c is less than or equal to 0. So here we will get f dash of c is greater than or equal to 0. Here we will get f dash of c is less than or equal to 0. But we know that f dash exists. So when the derivative exists, if the left hand derivative and the right hand derivative are equal. So clearly we should have f dash of c from the positive end and f dash of c from the negative end should be equal. So that is possible only in the one case when f dash of c is equal to 0. Hence the theorem. Thank you, students.